Listening Library presents Who Was Claude Monet? By Ann Waldron. Read for you by Arthur Morey. Who was Claude Monet? Claude Monet brought sunshine into painting. He was one of the first artists to work outdoors. That may not sound unusual to us, but before 1870, most artists did all their painting in studios. They used models dressed up as Greek gods or heroes from history. They painted with dark colors so their pictures would look more serious. They might have sometimes gone outside to draw a scene, but they always came back inside to paint the finished picture. Claude Monet and his artist friends broke the rules. Even as art students in Paris, they took their easels and paints and brushes outdoors to paint riverbanks or woods. They made trips to the seashore and painted all day long. They wanted to show the way sunlight made water and trees and boats look at different times during the day. If they painted people, they painted ordinary people in ordinary clothes. They used bright colors and painted quickly. For years, Monet earned hardly any money. Sometimes he could not pay the rent. Sometimes his family had no heat. Sometimes they went hungry. Still, Monet would not give up. Today he is one of the most famous artists ever. Paintings by Monet sell for millions of dollars and hang in museums all over the world. We are all lucky that Claude never stopped believing in his art. Chapter 1. A Boy Who Loved Drawing. The artist Claude Monet was born in Paris, France, on November 14, 1840. But when he was five, his family moved to Le Havre, a great seaport. As a boy, Claude hated school. His school was open only 2 hours in the morning and 2 hours in the afternoon. Still, he could barely stand it. School always made him feel like he was in a prison. When the sun was shining, he wanted to be outdoors in the fields or by the sea. Throughout his life, he was a person who never wanted to stick by the rules. Claude's father was a grocer. He sold supplies to the captains of the tall ships in the harbor. Claude loved to go down to the docks. He liked to watch the men unload cargo from ships. There was mahogany from South America, sugar from the West Indies, coffee beans from Java, tea from India, and dates from Persia. He liked to hear the men speaking foreign languages. Claude's mother died when he was 16. His aunt, Marie Jeanne, had no children of her own, so she helped to raise him. He was a tall, cheerful boy. He always liked to draw. He began drawing pictures of imaginary animals and funny pictures of his teachers. Claude also took drawing classes. His teacher taught the way everybody taught art then. Students first drew pictures of statues. After years of this, the students were allowed to draw living people. If they took classes long enough, the students would learn to paint. Claude did not like the teacher or the class. He kept on with his own drawing, using a pencil or pen and ink to turn out quick sketches of people in Le Havre. A store that sold art supplies framed his drawings and put them in the window. Claude sold many of his pictures. The store owner introduced him to a local painter. His name was Eugène Boudin. He liked to paint landscapes, pictures of nature. Boudin invited Claude to spend the day painting with him. Claude said no at first. Boudin's little pictures sold for far less money than Claude's cartoons. Then, one summer day, he gave in and bought some oil paints. Then he set out with Boudin for the country. Oil paints. When Monet was young, large paintings of historical scenes or myths were very popular. It might take an artist weeks, months, or even a year to complete a painting. Artists used sharp outlines for everything. Nothing was soft or blurred. They worked toward an absolutely perfect finish. This required at least 3 coats of paint. Until just before Monet began painting, French artists were still using the same kinds of oil paints that artists had used for 400 years. They had to grind their own pigments and mix their own paints. They used many earth-toned colors. There was no way to make good, bright, green paint. By the mid-19th century, new dyes for paints came along. Artists had new and brighter colors to use. About the same time, manufacturers figured out how to put oil paints in tubes with screw tops. Now artists could take their paints outdoors. Just in time for the Impressionists. Boudin was one of a handful of artists who painted outdoors. When Claude watched his new friend painting the sky and the fields exactly as they were, his eyes opened. Claude's life changed. He wanted to go to Paris to study painting. His father wanted him to go into the grocery business, but his aunt encouraged Claude. She, too, was a painter. In 1859, he left Le Havre for Paris. Claude was 18 years old. The money from his funny pictures was more than enough to support him. Paris was a dazzling city with cafes, nightclubs, and museums. Claude went to see the great art show known as the Salon. It was held every year in a giant glass-roofed hall. Every artist wanted his paintings to be in the Salon. Claude saw more than 2,000 pictures. They hung from floor to ceiling with their frames touching. All the paintings were the type that showed famous moments in history or myths. This type of art didn't interest Claude at all. He thought it looked depressing. He enrolled in classes at the Académie Suisse, which was free. Students contributed a little money to pay for a model and worked on whatever they wanted to. They could draw or paint with oils or watercolors. They could paint a live model, or they could work on a still life. They could come any time from early in the morning until late at night. For Claude, it was like being in heaven. Claude worked on his drawing. He made friends with an older student named Camille Pissarro. The two remained friends all their lives. Monet loved living in Paris, but in 1861, this exciting time came to an end. Why? Claude Monet had to join the French army. Chapter 2. A Rocky Start. Monet was sent to Algeria in northern Africa. He loved the heat and the light. He thought it was romantic to sleep in a tent in the desert. Zouave. The Zouave was the military unit that Monet joined in 1861. The first regiments were made of men from the Zouave region of Algeria. Later on, Frenchmen like Claude Monet were enlisted as well. The Zouave helped France conquer Algeria and fought for France in wars outside Africa. They played an important role in World War I. Zouave wore dashing uniforms with full red or white trousers tucked into shiny black boots that came up almost to the knee. They wore a wide sash across their chest and a long coat with a gold braid. A small cap topped off the outfit. Men were supposed to serve in the French army for 7 years, but after 2 years, Monet caught typhoid fever and was sent home on sick leave. That summer, in Le Havre, Monet continued to paint outdoors. He met a Dutch artist, Johan Bartholz Jonkind, who, like Boudin, painted outdoors. Jonkind and Boudin were his schoolmasters, Monet said later. Monet's aunt thought that his finished paintings looked like rough sketches, but she saw how hard Claude worked. So she paid the government to let Claude out of the army for good. Then she packed him off to Paris. His father promised him an allowance if he studied with a proper art teacher, so Monet tried more art classes. Monet's new teacher thought that he was a very good artist. However, he wanted Claude to make the models better looking than they really were. If their feet were too big, he thought Claude should make them smaller. Monet did not agree. Not at all. He thought you should paint what you saw. Nor did he like painting inside a crowded, noisy studio. But something wonderful came out of these classes. Three of the students, Pierre-Auguste Renoir, Alfred Sisley, and Frédéric Bazille, became close friends of Claude's. For years they all worked together. Bazille was a medical student. His parents paid for his art classes as long as he kept up with medical school. Renoir had started work as a china painter when he was only 13. Like Monet, he had saved enough money to come to Paris. Sisley was the lucky one, they all said. He was English. His father was a businessman in Paris and paid for his son's art studies without conditions. Monet's friends. Monet became close friends with Frédéric Bazille, Pierre-Auguste Renoir, and Alfred Sisley while studying at Charles Glaire's art studio in 1862. Bazille was born in Montpellier, France, in 1841, to a wealthy family. He often painted outdoors with Monet, but his paintings were more traditional. When the Franco-Prussian War broke out in 1870, Bazille joined the Zouave army. He was killed in action that same year. Renoir was born in Limoges, France, in 1841. He was the son of a working-class tailor. Renoir loved painting and created many lively portraits and scenes of social life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.